Okay, sorry students, we forgot record this meeting. So, hopefully all students follow this meeting because only part of this meeting that we can upload in my class. Because I'm sorry, we are forget record this meeting from the beginning. So, if your friends ask to you, how about our meeting today, please help us to explain to your friend, yeah, because we forgot to record from the beginning. We only record from start from now, gitu
From
ya.
now.
So please tell to your friend if someone didn't follow this meeting and ask to you. Okay, and then move into the 15 meeting, yeah. 14 meeting. In 14 and also 15 meeting, we are talking about the human resources. It is human resources evaluations, yeah. How to evaluate the human resources that we lead, yeah. So we should make evaluations whether our employee is already suitable for us, their job is already good, or still need any improvement. So we need to evaluate our employee. It is also used for giving the reward and also punishment for our employee, because if someone's has a good performance, good job performance, so he or she should get the rewards, yeah, because he or she is already done a good performance. But if someone's or your employees got bad performance, it should be also evaluated, because the performance of the individual on the performance of the employee will make an impact of the organizational's performance also. So it is talking about the work performance evaluations. The good performance will get reward, and also the bad performance will get the sanctions, yeah, for the bad performance. Okay, or punishments. And this activity also practical skills, how to evaluate of our employee. Yeah? It is in Indonesians we use apa namanya, Mbak? Sasaran kerja pegawai, SKP,
SKP,
ya,
LPKP,
and also perilaku
kinerja pegawai.
kinerja pegawai. It is actually in human resources literature called as 360 degree evaluations. 360 degree evaluations conducted in Indonesia by implementing the sasaran kerja pegawai and also perilaku kerja pegawai. So in Indonesian case, just for information for Malaysian student, that the government employee will got the evaluations of four indicator of their job. The first indicator is talking about the quality of the quality, ya, Mbak, the quality of their performance. And then the second indicator that will evaluate is the quantity of their job. The third indicator is about the time, how they can manage their job. It is suitable with in the time or not. And then the last one is talking about the budget, yeah, whether the budget that use in their job is already suitable or not. So there are five indicators to evaluate the performance of our employee. And also not only the performance, the job performance that evaluate, it is also the attitude the attitude of our employee, the attitude of our employee that will evaluate this yeah, talking about the teamwork and there are at least six attitude that will evaluate in human resources development, yeah. The discipline, the teamwork, the what else, Mbak Ellen, and the public
Orientation to the
service.
public service,
Ma,
yeah.
okay. And then the last one, we will have 16 meeting, yeah, final examinations. Okay. Okay, I forgot to explain to you that for the midterm examinations that we will conduct in 8 meeting, the topic that will appear in midterm examination is the second topics until the 7 topics, yeah. The second topic until the 7 topic will appear in midterm examinations, while in final examinations, and the topic that will appear is 9 meeting until the 15 meeting, yeah, of the our lecture. Okay, and how about the score distribution, Mbak Helen? Can you
right,
explain
so,
to students?
Yeah, so in the slide you already see that we have at least four score assessment. First is for assignment, quiz, and also the forum. It will be 20%, practical skill 25%, midterms 25%, and final examination 25%. But the things is because yeah, in my class we try to use the new one that made by university. So at least in the assignment, quiz, forum, and also the practical skill, we will merge by one point. I mean, like you will have the 50% point, and then the 50% point we will divide into 10 activities at least. So because if you count in the first meeting, I mean next meeting until last meeting, you will have at least 5 practical skill, and then for 5 practical skill, of course you will give the assignment. I mean, after after Pak Awang give the theoretical, and then I give you how to, you know, how to do the practical, and then you will give the assignment to do that kind of the practical. So 5 we will have 5 practical skills, and then for assignment, quiz, and forum, we also have 5 activities. So make sure, yeah, as I mentioned before, that you should make sure that you can access the My Class, because from next meeting, I mean from second meeting, you will start the activity. I mean, I and Pak Awang will give you for example assignment, or maybe just a discussion forum, or maybe I will give you a quiz. So all the information I will give to you to the WhatsApp forum, I mean WhatsApp group. But for the, you know, to update the materials, and then to update the tasks that you have to do, you should actually frequently to open your My Class. So that's the thing. So once again, for the assignment, quiz, practical skill, it will be merged by one assessment. So you will have the 50% for assignment, quiz, forum, practical, and also skill. So in each part, I mean, we have 10 activities, right? 10 activities for practical, assignment, quiz, and also forum. Each part or each task, you will have a 5% point. So if you miss one, for example, one quiz or one forum or one practical, so you will miss the 5% point. Understand? So, well, I just to make sure, I just make sure to you that please pay attention in WhatsApp group and also frequently to open your my class, because all the materials, all the things that you should to do, we provide in my class. So for the WhatsApp group, we just give you the information. Like for example, student, you will have the forum, or you will have the quiz, and then quiz only can access by 3 p.m. until maybe 9 p.m. So just make sure all the things you can pass. So I think Pak Awang will give you a very good score. I mean, A is easy, but the things is you cannot pass. You cannot you know, you cannot at least one or two you cannot left pass behind. The yeah left behind. So just please attention for that things.
Okay, how about the score, Belen? I forgot.
For
grade A, if you got.
Yeah, I already upload also in okay. My class, and then you can see. Well, actually, the score is still same with the university standard. So if you want to get A score, at least you have 80.
Above 80.
Above 80.
And AB?
AB,
yeah. Okay, next we will open the rector.
Oh, this one.
Rector. Okay.
So for A, it's above 80, and then AB is from 75 until 80, and then B, you can start from 65 until 75, BC 60 until 65, C. It's for C until A, you can pass the lecture 50. At least you got 50 if you want to just pass the lecture. But if you want to got the very good score, at least you got for average is 80. But for below 50, you will got D and E. So it means that you have to repeat your this lecture, or maybe yeah, in your transcript you will cut D or E.
Okay. Okay, done. Okay, yeah. Cukup ya, Mbak, ya. Okay, any questions, students?
Yeah, maybe if you still have any question, please just
any questions are already clear enough?
Maybe it's enough, sir.
Okay, good. Okay, yeah. So it is finished for today, and soon I will give you a ebook for your handbook in this lecture, yeah. And as I said before, that the final ebook you still has waiting for around maybe 2 or 3 weeks. Today I will give you the draft first. Okay, yeah, I will give you the draft. The substantion between the draft and also the final book is already same. The difference is only in designs, in cover, in pages that already still miss in this book draft, yeah. So today's I will give you I will share in your WA groups, yeah, the file of the handbook, and please read chapter 1, yeah, please read chapter 1, especially that talking about the, the definitions and also the goals and the benefits of human resources management, because that material we will use in this in the next meeting next week, yeah. Okay, apa Mbak Ellen?
Pak Awang, don't forget for student to attend click the attendance on my class, because it already made by the university. And then please just let me know if someone cannot click the attendance. I mean, like you still get the errors or maybe some trouble. So please let me know, because Mbak Kinan as the admin of my class will fix the your problem.
Okay, so once again, students, if you have any obstacle, if you have any problem with my class, please call Mbak Helen. Don't call me because I'm lack of technology, yeah. So Mbak Helen, I'm nothing without Mbak Helen, gitu ya.
I'm nothing
in
too
technology,
without Pao.
Yeah. So please call Mbak Helen if you have any problem with my class. How about Malaysian student? Mbak Nurul and friends, please ask Mbak Adiba.
I already asked Miss Adiba. Our IB student is still on process.
Oh, okay, on process. Okay.
So don't be worried. And then don't forget to you just click the attendance until 11 p.m. So after that you cannot present. You cannot click the attendance. But for the Malaysian student, I think we will count on next week, yeah, Pak Awang, because something that still be fixed for the student ID.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. No questions? Clear, yeah? Okay. Thank you, students. See you next week in video learning, yeah? Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Pak Awan,
terima kasih, Pak.
Terima kasih.